Allah has blessed us with youth and good health. Of these qualities are our greatest wealth.
Follow the guidance of the Holy Quran by shunning all evil and following Islam.
Obey your parents and give them due respect. Be a perfect model to your kids and morally correct.
Help your kids and always be fair.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. It's my pleasure to be with you here today to continue about our program, Family Issues. And with the previous episodes, we talk about the importance of the marriage in Al-Islam and how Islam view marriages and the necessity of marriage and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had give us and bless us with a spouse or with a partner that for us to be able to function, to do our duties in this life, to carry our obligations as Muslims, to be able to carry our duties in this life. And today, after we already heard about this, which is supposed to be, inshallah, encouragement for you to at least, if you are not going to go ahead and get married, at least you already had to start thinking about marriage. And we already described about the importance of getting married. And today, inshallah, we want to talk about the issue of searching, choosing, selecting your partner. You now about to do, take a different step, and now a new homework for you to start to select and choose your other half, your partner. You are going in a journey. It's not an easy journey. It's not going to be a road that full with flowers and smell good and relaxation is going to be a journey, and it's going to be a long journey. And it's very important to make sure that you do the right selection for this long journey. As we stated before, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about the relationship between a man and a woman, between a husband and wife, and he call it mithaqan ghalidha, that a strong and serious commitment. We don't marry every day. We did not get married for a month or for 1 year or for a couple of years. So as a result of this, from now, I'm telling you, you need to get the right partner. You need to make the right choice, because now you're going to have the good or the bad of your decisions that you're going to make it today. So Islam, alhamdulillah, encourage us about marriage, and also he gave us the proper way and the proper selection, how to go about selecting your partner. And we start here with Surah An-Nur, verse number 32, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in his book, وَانْكِحُوا الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّالِحِينَ مِنْ عِبَادِكُمْ وَإِمَائِكُمْ إِنْ يَكُونُوا فُقَرَاءَ يُغْنِهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, marry al-ayama, the plural of ayim. And the ayim is a man who has no wife, or a woman which has no husband. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving order to the awliya, to the guardians, the fathers, those who are in charge of their daughters, or those people who are in charge of making a decision about a marriage, say, وَانْكِحُوا الْأَيَامَ, marry those who are single among you. Give them in marriage or for them to get married. الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمْ and وَالصَّالِحِينَ, the righteous one. So number one is going to be a single. You could not make a proposal. You could not go think about marrying a woman that is already married. Neither you can try to spoil a relationship of a husband and wife because your selfish needs and wants. There is many, many women, and there is many, many men that you are there looking for marriage. So he said, number one, al-ayama, those who are not married, those who are single among you. Number two, as-salihin, the righteous one among you. So our selection have to be for as-salihin, male or female as-salihin. And he said, min ibadikum wa imaikum, regardless if you are a free man or you are a slave person, still marriage can be for you and be for you as a male or female. If you are in captivity, in slavery, it's still for you to get married. But why here's a mention specifically about your ima, your abid? Because mostly those people, they did not have the ability of paying the dowry or the full dowry. They did not have the means to support. And he said, إِن يَكُونُوا فُقَرَاءَ يُغْنِهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. If they are poor, if they are needy, if they did not have the means for the marriage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assist them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a means for them. إِن يَكُونُوا فُقَرَاءَ يُغْنِهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from His blessings, from His bounties, He will make ways and means for them. So we have to understand from now on that there is a condition and there is certain requirements and there is certain description and qualities for the man that you're going to marry or the woman that you're going to marry. Is what? Salihin, righteous. And also we learn something very important. If you're serious with this marriage, to protect your private parts and to lower your gaze and to be a better Amatullah and a better Abdullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make means. He will assist you. He will make a means for you. So those who have economic problems, they have to start to think about marriage. But do you really trust in Allah or not? Allah will make a way for you. If you want with this marriage to protect yourself from falling into the haram, and with intention to be a better Muslim and a better Muslima, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your marriage a means of a new income for you and provision for you. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in support of this also is saying, وَلَا تُنْكِحُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا. This Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 221. Don't give your daughters in marriage except for those who are Muslims, those who are believers. You could not give your daughter for a kafir. And because the kafir is not equivalent, is not equal, he could not be a partner for your daughter. Neither a man can be equal to a Muslim woman. Let's make a stop here, and inshallah, stay tuned. We'll be back right away. Thank you for watching.
Allah has blessed us with youth and good health.
If you're 18 or if you're 80, if you've been Muslim for 50 years or 5 minutes, this is a show for you. You know, when five times a day our foreheads touch the ground in prayer, we beg for what's most important in our lives. We want to be good people, better Muslims. We want to serve Allah Almighty with all our hearts. In this show, Let's Talk, every week we're going to talk about Islam and life, how to relate with other people and how to serve Allah. We'll have studio guests, we'll have a live studio audience. There'll be an email for you to write to, talk@huda.tv. So if you're looking for something different, looking for something that will make you think, maybe even touch your heart, this is the show for you.
Allah has blessed us with youth and good health.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. Welcome back. We continue talking about choosing and selecting the right partner for our journey in this life, my husband or my wife. Now we said as-salihin, and is no mushrik can be a salih. Righteousness comes as a result of belief. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 221, وَلَا تُنْكِحُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ حتى يؤمنوا. Don't give your daughters to the mushrik until they believe. So the belief is a main requirement, is a special quality. And we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, إنما المشركون نجس. You are a believer, you are tayyib, you are good, you are pure. The state of heart is in iman. So a kafir and a believer could not be under the same roof, could not be under the same cover, could not be in a intimate relationship. Therefore, that the salah comes as a result of the iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us clear in Quran that a slave servant that is a believer is much better than a kafir, even if you admire him. He looks good, the way how he dresses, the type of a car that he's driving. Still, this is not enough quality to make him a future husband. Neither can make her a future wife for you. Why? Because the kufr, the disbelief, this will make the difference. More clearer than this, even for Muslims, it's not any Muslims that you can marry. You have to select. Why? Because nowadays we see some people getting married to a woman that is not even making salah. Some people, they marry a man that he is not even making the five-time prayers. He go for Jum'ah and they say, no, by no means. Listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showing us the quality and who that we're going to take him as a partner. He said, تنكح المرأة لأربع لمالها ولحسبها ولدينها ولجمالها فاظفر بذات الدين تربت يداك. A man proposed to a woman, or a man will admire a woman, seek marriage out of a woman for one of these three qualities. He may marry her because her beauty. He may marry and propose to her because her lineage, from tribe so and so, family so and so. He may propose for her because her wealth. So all this acceptable, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling you, fadfar bi dhati ad-din. Get a woman that have religion, have the proper belief, the proper practice, the proper aqidah. Otherwise, your hand will be close to dust. That means you will be a misfortune. You will be miserable all your life. But doesn't negate the fact that I have to go look for the most ugliest woman or the most ugliest man. And there is nothing called the most ugliest, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. All the creation of Allah is good, but we have different selection, different taste. So, but some of us maybe prefer a woman with a long hair. The other person, short hair to him is not what he pleases with, but to somebody else, he's looking for a woman with short hair. So it's a different moods, different types, different taste. But there is no negation for the fact a woman can look for some beauty. But don't make the beauty to me your main concern in a woman. Because beauty is not going to stay forever. Maybe she's 25 years old and the cheeks are red and the lips is small and the eyes is green and the hair is long. But what's going to happen after 10, 15 years? Now what's going to happen? What about if a woman have money and this is your main concern? There is no guarantee the money will go be always there. But the deen, this is the foundation. And if the deen there and she don't have too much beauty, too much wealth, too much of this and that, now the religion and the piety and the submission to Allah and His Messenger and the obedience to the husband, because her belief, this will take over and make up for whatever that is not enough of her money or her beauty, all these things. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given us advice, fadfar bi dhati ad-din. Marry a woman, make sure this woman, she have taqwa of Allah, believe in Allah. Otherwise, you could not be a winner. Also, something that we need to take it in consideration is al-afaf. A Muslim woman is what we're looking for, but also her characteristic, her practice of the deen. Because as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us, al-mu'min al-qawi khayru wa ahabu ila Allah min al-mu'min al-da'if. People are different. Like you say, your fingers are not the same. You have one longer than others. You have one fatter than the other. So you can look in one hand, these fingers are not the same. So it's not because somebody we call it Muslim that this is enough. Some people in the passport, they say a Muslim. Although in our passports, they did not write Muslim, Christian, Jew, whatever it is, US, and this it, okay? But in other countries, they said religion, and they will write Muslim, Christian, like this. So it's not enough because in the ID card that it say Muslim. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us, لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن. A person commit adultery, he doesn't fornicate while he in a state of a full iman. So the iman has degree, and the iman as the according the aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, according the aqidah of the Sahaba and the early companions and the tabi'in, yazid wa yankus, increase and decreases. So it's not because a woman is a Muslim this enough. It can be a Muslim and drinks. It can be a Muslim and fornicate. It can be a Muslim and a steal. So why I'm saying this? Because some people say, oh, her name is Aisha. Her name is Khadija. Her name is Amatullah. But this is not enough. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن. You could not be fornicating while you are in a total perfection of faith. We can be in a state of Islam. So, why I'm saying this? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still there. He forbid for us from marrying a woman who prostituting themselves. That they took this as a hijab or as occupation. Or is not even they do it for occupation. It may be something they do it for fun. But this kind of women, we could not marry them. Okay? So, because this is defect in their Islam and in their characteristic, their manner, their discipline. So we have to stay away from this. We could not select this woman, even if she's the most beautiful woman, unless that she repent. This is because at-tawbah tajubbu ma qablaha, that true repentance will remove all the sins that been committed before. Therefore, it is very important that a woman not to be a sinful woman, is not a woman that expose herself to the public, doesn't care about her personality, how she presents herself to the people. And this is something that it have to be taken in consideration. We understand that many or some good number among the Muslims, okay, they used to be non-Muslims. And boyfriend as a, and girlfriend is something is well known. Nobody look upon it to be something bad. Even if you are doesn't have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, your parents and you are 20 years old or 10 years old, they look something wrong with our child. But Islam doesn't see this. So we talk into this because some of us think because a woman or a man had fornicated or committed adultery or have illegal sexual intercourse before they took their shahada, we could not marry them. No, we're talking about a people who took this act as a professional or as a hobby or is like a sports to them. Those people, we could not marry them. Even if they took shahada, unless they took shahada and they make a sincere repentance from such act. But this does not make this marriage forbidden if she had took shahada and she had repent sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to take this in consideration about being a woman that we call afifa. Doesn't matter if she's a Muslim or from Ahlul Kitab, which we will talk about it. So in addition to the righteousness and the iman, the iffah have to be in the woman that you have to know that she is not a woman who prostitute herself for with this kind of things is forbidden. وَحُرِّمَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, which is the adultery and fornication or marrying from the women who do such act. Now, it is very important to understand about ittihad al-deen or the same belief. This is something that we have to understand about when we proposing for a woman to marry her. And we are going to already said about ittihad al-deen, وَلَا تُنْكِحُوا الْمُشْرِكِينَ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا, that you could not give your daughter to the mushriks until they believe. And also, you could not marry a man even if you admire him. But the difference here is one thing is very important to pay attention to it. A man can marry a woman from Ahlul Kitab, Jew or a Christian. But a woman, a Muslim woman, could not marry from the men of Ahlul Kitab. This is something very important. We have to understand this. This is not permissible. So we're talking about a man who is Muslim can propose or choose from Ahlul Kitab, which is a different subject. We're going to talk about it. But iman and salah and taqwa and iffa is very important when we marry from the Muslim women. But if a Muslim woman, she has to choose and select the same thing like a man, and she have to understand that which man she can accept his proposal. But A Muslim woman could not marry a Christian or a Jew, and this is forbidden, and we have to take this in consideration. And if it happened, and if it happened, this is not going to be considered a marriage. Doesn't matter if the father agree, doesn't matter if the wali attends the wedding, doesn't matter if they get a certificate from the city hall. A Muslim girl, a Muslim woman could not marry a Jew or a Christian. Is anything else we can take it in consideration when we talk about marriage? And what about marriage from the people of the book? And what about the marriage of people that Jewish or a Christian, or that they are not in the same tribes, the same colors, like some of the problems you see nowadays, that guardians say, okay, you could not marry this because he's not Arab like us, he is not Bangladesh like us, he is not Indo-Pakistani like us, he is not this, he is not that. These things, inshallah, we understand. I realize that one of the main problems that facing teenagers, boys and girls, in our midst, especially those now who are in the university, they get to see each other, they get to be liking each other, and now after they feel that this is my right partner, this is my right mate for the future, the problem comes when the father say, you could not do this. He is not from our background. But due to the fact that we could not go in details now, inshallah, looking forward that you be with us again in continuation of family issues, we're going to give more details for this, inshallah. But we're going to have to stop here because of the time. But until I see you again, inshallah, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to get the right partner. I make the dua for me and you. Okay? So don't worry, the dua is not for you only. We always start ourselves with the dua that Allah give us the guidance that we select the right partner, if it's me or you. Until I see you again, I'm your host, Mohammad Sayed Adli, from Columbia, South Carolina, United States of America. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.
Allah has blessed us with youth and good health. Of these qualities are our greatest wealth.
Follow the guidance of the Holy Quran by shining all evil and following Islam.